Moments in your life when you've been a sucker. You've allowed yourself to be tricked into doing something. You've allowed yourself to believe in something that wasn't real. Maybe you have been cheated on before and you forgave your gaslighting girlfriend. Maybe you have been duped into buying a useless online course by your everyday fake guru. These moments of naivete are common and a part of the human condition. The following are some tips on how to avoid being a sucker. They might appear simple, but when internalized, they are highly effective. Number 1. Despise the free lunch. Nothing in life is free. That's the law of alchemy. There is always a catch, a trick, a hidden obligation. Remember this fact whenever you are offered something. Generosity is often hidden ambition. When you deserve what you have, you are neither a prisoner to guilt nor gratitude. All things of excellence are worth the price tag. There's a popular saying in Japan that goes, Tadayori takai mono wa nai. Meaning, nothing is more costly than something given free of charge. The unspoken way, Michihiro Matsumoto. Number 2. Don't think that everyone wants the best for you. One of the most common traps we fall into is to believe that everyone is good and full of well intentions. Just because you're kind doesn't mean that everyone is like you. There are people out there who seek destruction. Some hurt us just because we're standing in their way, and others who unconsciously manipulate us under the cover of being nice, naive, or even moral. Just because someone smiled or flattered you, it doesn't mean they won't talk behind your back or toss you away when you are of no use to them. The world is rather harsh and human beings are wired to survive. Judge people by their actions and monitor their consistency. If you choose to stay blind, don't blame your friends, the gods, or Tom Cruise for your misfortunes. Ultimately, you are your own undertaker. 3. Don't reveal too much. Oversharing is not only dangerous since you reveal your thoughts, fantasies, and past behaviors, but it can also be seen as impolite. Not everyone is comfortable or even interested. Yes, we all want to be heard and understood at least to a certain extent, and yes, sharing things can be cathartic. Just do it in a safe, trusted environment. Remember the following Chinese proverb: mastering discretion is greater than employing eloquence. The more you reveal of yourself, the more rope you give others to hang you with. Most of what you think, you should keep to yourself. Number 4. Don't develop dependency. Malcolm X traced dependency as the root of the problems of the African American community, a dependency on the government, liberals, and their leaders instead of themselves. When you are dependent on others for things, you have no options. When you have no options, you have no power. When you have no power, you dance to the music of others. You eat up whatever they give you. You choose from the cards they deal. That shouldn't be you. Make sure all your debts are paid and all your needs are self-fulfilled. Remember, the first step towards all slavery is dependency. Number 5. Know your tics and weaknesses. Self-awareness of your shortcomings is an advantage. It's easier to predict psychological attacks when you see them coming. An insult that would have inflamed your ego can be matched with indifference. When you notice your susceptibility to flattery, you are less likely to be moved by it. When you shine the light on how easily corruptible you are, you try harder to abstain. A simple moment of introspection can minimize your moments of weakness. Ask yourself, what makes me tick? What gets on my nerves? What do I resent in others? How can someone use this knowledge to manipulate me? Number 6. Don't think you are immune to manipulation. This is the downfall of the clever. Smart people often forget how they became smart. The nights of toil they spent learning their craft, crafting their intellectual prowess, and learning the social dynamics necessary to navigate the world. They start believing in their own myth, not capable of imagining someone smarter than they are. Don't get cocky. That's when you are most vulnerable to manipulation. If you think you won, you are probably a part of someone else's game. Number 7. Don't get attached too quickly. We spend our lives projecting ourselves on others, living through them, and reinforcing our identities through attaching it to ideas, people, places, and so on. When you emotionally cling too quickly, you are more likely to get hurt. Some people aren't worth the investment. Others take time to show their true intentions. Take your time building your relationships. How many people rush into a romantic relationship and end up getting love-bombed and abused? When you feel you're getting too attached, take a step back from the object of attachment and assess the why. If someone is rushing you to make a hasty decision, it's often a sign of a trap. Remember, good things take time. Number 8. Don't believe all you hear. Our first inclination is to believe the words of others without much thinking. After all, why would they lie to us? Nowadays, we are bombarded by information from all types of sources. We have no clue what to accept or deny, so that part of us that seeks comfort kicks in and drops the ball. We believe a lot of things simply because we are too tired to think twice, or because we want to believe in something. So much pain can be avoided if we just put in a little effort in critically assessing what the environment is telling us. Next time your friend friend tells you about that great deal, or your coworker complains about your boss, Janice is such an unbearable idiot, take a step back and think if that deal is too good to be true, or if that coworker is sent by the boss to test your loyalty. Things are rarely what they seem. Number 9. Understand the function of manipulation. Manipulation is not bad. It's a part of life, a survival mechanism. You manipulate people on a daily basis when you try to convince them to do things for you, when you manage their perceptions of who you are. Abandon this rigid and naive understanding. It's your responsibility to yourself and others to master the art of psychological defense. If you choose to spend time around toxic snakes, don't be surprised when they bite you. I'll take more time working on those Death Note scripts since a subscriber wants a longer video. If you'd like to support the channel, watch the videos you haven't watched yet. Thank you.